Okay, so let's see the program over here. We have started with normal hash include commands. Then void main, we defined array A of size 5, I variable as index variable, L variable to consider what is the last index to be processed, that will be changing in the program. Then T variable for swapping the values. Then we have defined a for loop to input array. Then the actual sorting logic will start. Now what we're doing over here, let's see. As a first step, let's observe only this step, what is happening over here in this area. First, we decided the last index to be processed according to array size. In this case, since array size is 5, we have decided last index to be processed is L equal to 4. Then we have to take one variable I from 0 to last index and compare consecutive elements, that is ith and I plus 1 element. If I plus 1 element is smaller, interchange. So to move through the array, obviously we'll be writing a for loop. For loop I goes from 0 to I less than L I plus plus. Now why this I less than L is because we'll be comparing ith and I plus 1 number. If we take I up to L, that is up to 4, then compare 4th and 5th element, which is wrong. Okay, now for every ith value, what to do? You have to compare I plus 1 value is less than ith value, then interchange. So here we'll put the condition, if A of I plus 1 value is less than A of ith value, then interchange them. To interchange, we'll use our third variable T, temporary variable, and I'm writing a logic for interchanging over here. So that is the logic for interchanging ith and I plus 1 number, and then the loop of I will stop. Now let's see what this part is doing. It's actually working on this array, original array, and giving you this next part of the array. Now initially L is set to 4, then the for loop will start, I equal to 0, and then this time it compares is A1 less than A0. Since A1 less than A0, we'll interchange A1 and A0, so that is 4 moves up, 6 down. Again, I plus was occurs, I becomes 1. It compares this time A2 is less than A1. A2 less than A1 is false. We are working over here now. So 8 remains as it is. There's no change. I becomes 2. It compares is A3 less than A2. Yes, true. So 3 moves up. So 3 goes up and 8 down. Again, it compares, again I plus 1 occurs, I becomes 3, it compares A4 less than A3, A4 less than A3 is 2, so again 5 moves up and 8 down. So you got, then again I plus 1, I becomes 4, and the loop will stop. Now you got 4, 6, 3, 5, and 8. That is, you got the largest number at the bottom. Now once this procedure is done, we have to repeat this again for L equal to 3. Then for 2, then for 1. This we have done for L equal to 4 only. So you have to repeat this procedure for, that is this procedure you have to repeat for L equal to 4 to L greater than 0 with L decrementing as minus minus. So what happens over here overall is, first L is set to 4. This loop will go from 0 to 4 and work on the first array. Again L becomes 3. This for loop will go from 0 to 3 in the array and do the sorting accordingly. Again L becomes 2, this for loop will go 0 to 2 and work with the part of the array. Again L becomes 1, this goes from 0 to 1 and works with the part of the array. When L becomes 0, the list loop will stop and we'll get the sorted array. Now this sorted array we have to display in the output. So after this we'll write a for loop. We'll first print a message, sorted arrays as follows, and the entire array will be output on new line A0 to A4. Thank you.